Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install CodeBlocks and to use it for C and C++ programming. So first you need to go to favorite browser and to type over here CodeBlocks download. Hit enter. So that will show you this codeblocks.org. So just simply go to their official site. So this link I am going to provide right in our channel description. Once when you are here, you will see this download to the binary release. So just simply click on that and it could redirect to these binary releases. And here when you scroll down, you are going to see this Microsoft Windows 64-bit default. So you are going to download and install it for Windows and you'll be able to see all these different links. From here, I'll always recommend you to download these CodeBlocks with MinGW setup. Always remember to download CodeBlocks which also has MinGW setup, because we want to compile our C and C++ program. So for that, we need a compiler. Alright, so we are going to use this MinGW compiler for doing that. So that's why it is very important to download CodeBlocks which will also has MinGW compiler. So just click on this sourceforge.net link corresponding to that and it's going to redirect to the SourceForge page and it's going to immediately start downloading. By the way, I'm going to also provide this link on our channel description so that you don't miss out, you know, downloading CodeBlocks which also has MinGW. So thank you for downloading our MinGW with CodeBlocks is right started downloading. Can close this because I have already downloaded it and here is our CodeBlocks. You can see already downloaded. So just simply double click on that installer. Luxify administrative privileges, click on yes. So CodeBlocks version 25.03 slightly opened. So welcome to CodeBlocks setup. Click on next. So that's going to show you this license agreement. You must read this and click on agree. And this is what I was talking about. So at the very beginning of the video. So we need to have MinGW compiler also along with CodeBlocks. So that's why always download CodeBlocks which also has MinGW compiler. So that is why it is showing MinGW compiler suit. Alright, so just simply click on next. Again, click on install and that going to immediately start installing our CodeBlocks. So this installing CodeBlocks will take some time, couple of minutes. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you please do like, share and subscribe. That going to really motivate me to make more and more the similar kind of videos. So let's wait for a few minutes over here. So we'll come back. So now you can clearly see that our CodeBlocks is rightly installed. Our desktop shortcut also created over here. So we want to run CodeBlocks now. So for that, just simply click on yes. So our CodeBlocks is started opening. You need to click on next and you need to click on finish over here. And our CodeBlocks is rightly started opening. Here in compiler auto detection, you can see when you scroll down, you will see this MinGW GCC compiler is detected, right? So that is what I was talking at the very beginning of the video. So we need to have MinGW compiler as well. So that's why you can see it is detected now. So now we are good. We can compile our code. So just simply click on OK. And our CodeBlocks is rightly open. Here you can select as per your wish. I'm going to select this yes, associate CodeBlocks with C and C++ file type, because that is what I'm going to use CodeBlocks for C and C++ programming. And this is the interface of our CodeBlocks. So let's do a bit of coding. So first go to file and hover over new and click on empty file. So that's going to open this empty file. Here let's write a simple C program. So hash include stdio.h and then we are going to create a int main method and within that let's first create a curly brace and let's print something on our console. So let's print something like hello world. Alright, just write this much, end with a semicolon, and you can return something also on your console. So let's return 0. We have to return 0 because it is an int main method. It expects something integer to be returned, so that's why we have written we need to return 0. So write this much, go to file and click on save as. So let's go to our desktop and save this file as, let's say, prog or program.c. So we need to save it in a .c extension because it is a C program. For C++ program, you need to save it as .cpp. So like this, .cpp, if it is a C++ program. And obviously you need to write a C++ code snippet for that. I'm going to save it as a .c and click on save. So our file program.c is rightly saved over here. So when you click on run button over here, it's going to tell you whether you like to build it now. Yes, we want. Click on yes. And there you go. You can see the output coming on our console, right? Hello world. So whatever you have written, so that output is properly coming. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of CodeBlocks and you can start working on your C and C++ programming. If you are also interested on Python, then please do follow this cool Python project playlist. I am sure you are going to love them. So all these different videos, starting from turning a text into realistic speech or building a Python face detector, you know, from scratch using just 10 lines of Python code, or converting a text to a handwritten script, or even building your very own QR code. So you can learn basically each and every detail about Python by following these playlists. So detailed source code also are available on our geekyscript.com official website. So you can see this entire full source code, like full GUI code you are going to get. You can copy it, you can paste it, and you can create your very own project as well. And if you want to refer, you can refer our video tutorials, so that will help you to learn what you are actually doing. Alright, so do check out our Python video playlist, and also if you're interested on WordPress or any other videos, so that also you can check out on our channel. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.